Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain you how to write an algorithm so that we can sort a singular interest, right? So before starting the algorithm, let me explain this diagram. So here you can see we have three nodes and each node is having two parts. One is info and second one is next call link that will be holding the address of next node. And initially we have start that is having address of first node. So I already explained this diagram in detail in my previous video. So if you want to watch that video, you can go to description of this video and you will find link of a playlist. So in that playlist, I have sum up all the videos related to data structure. So you can find that video there and you can watch that. Now I'm going to write the algorithm so that we can sort a linked list. So I'm going to use this diagram for reference purpose. So name of algorithm will be sort. It will be having three parameters as start. Second will be info and then length. So start is having address of first node. Info is the value part of each node and length is the length is holding address of next node always. So we are going to use three things in the algorithm. So step number one will be set p1 equals to start. So start is basically having initial address of node one, so that is stored in p1 pointer. So this is step number one. Then step number two will be repeat. So I'm going to start the loop. So repeat steps. So we are going to step repeat certain steps. So step will be p to 5 while p1 not equals to null. Right. So if p1 is not equals to null, then this loop will be iterating and it will be repeating step number 3, 4, and 5. Now, step number 3 will be set. So here again, we need to set one more pointer, that is p2. So here p1 is pointing to start and p2 will be pointing to length of p1. So starting from this point, so p1 is pointing to 1001 and p1 is not equal to null, then link of p1. So p1's link is 2001 that will be stored into p2. So p2 will be pointing to second node. Right? Now, step number 4. So at step number 4, again, I need to implement a loop. So repeat step. So here we need to repeat some steps. So instead of step, I am writing set because I am going to write some steps like A, B, C, D here along with the if condition. So those we are going to repeat. So repeat set while P2 not equals to null. Right? And what set of statement will be repeated? I am writing that. So now we need to implement if condition. So if info of p1 is greater than info of p2. So p1 is pointing to first node, p2 is pointing to second node. If information part, that is 10, is greater than info of p2, that is 20, so this condition will be true, right? So when this condition will be true, then we need to perform these three operations, A, B, C. And these three operations will be swapping of these two values. So let's say this is having 40. So 40 is greater than 20. So in that case, we need to swap these two values so that 20 can come here and 40 can go here. So right now I am writing set t equals to. So t is a temporary variable which can store values. Info of p1. So info of p1 will be stored into t. Then set info of P1 equals to info of P2. So P2 info will be stored into P1, and that is that info of P2 equals to T. So these are simple swapping statements. We are basically swapping values of node 1 with node 2. So 20 will come here and 40 will go there. Right? Then end of if. So this if will be stopped here. Then we need to complete this loop. So after completion of this if, I am writing set P2 equals to link of P2. So this statement will also repeat with this loop, right? And after this, I can write end of stack for loop. So this stack number 4 loop will end here, right? So why I mention this? Because P2 is right now pointing to this position. So first we are comparing this node with this, and then this also. So for that purpose I mentioned this. So it will be pointing to third node, and third node will be compared with the value of first node. So basically what we are doing, we are comparing first node value with all other nodes, and we are trying to figure out the smallest number that can be stored here. And we will pick second node, and this second node value will be compared with other remaining nodes, and the next smallest element will be stored here, right? So this way we are going to sort the elements. Now after this end of stack number 4 loop, I need to write next step. So that is stack number 5, set P1 equals to link of P1, right? So P1 will be moved to next location, and after this I can write end of stack 2 loop. So this loop will be terminated, and then stack 6 will be end. So now I'm going to execute the statements which are mentioned here, so that you can see how this linked list will be sorted. So let's say 40, 20, and 30 are the values. So P1 is pointing to 1001 due to this. Then this condition is true. P2 is again 2001 due to this. Then P2 is not equals to null. Then compare this. Info of P1 is greater than info of P2. So 40 is greater than 20. It is true. Then we need to swap the values. So here 20 and here 40 will be stored. Then only P2 will be moved. So P2 is right now pointing to this location, and its link is 3001. So new value of P2 will be 3001, because this is in a loop. This is in a loop which is repeating. So P2 is not equal to null. So this time, this value will be compared with this. So 20 is less than 30. So this swapping will not perform. Then P2 will again include link of P2. So that is null. So this time P2 is null. So this loop will be terminated. Now we need to move P1. So P1 will be pointing to link of P1. So P1 is this. Its link is 2001. So this time P1 will be pointing to this location. Now check this step number 2. It is true. P1 is not null. Now P2 will begin from link of P1. So P1 is 2001. That is second node. Its link is 3001. That will lead to P2. So P2 will begin from here. Right? Now P2 is not equal to null. Now check this. Info of P1 is 40. Info of P2 is 30. So it is 2. Again swapping will be performed. So 30 will come here and 40 will go here. Right? So this way you can see changes happen. Then P2 will move to link of P2. So P2 is pointing to 3001 and its link is null. So again this is pointing to null position. So this condition is false. Now P1 will move to link of its node. So P1 is pointing to 2001. Its link is 3001. Then this condition is true. P2 will be pointing to link of P1. So link of P1 is null. So P2 is null. It means this loop will not repeat. It will be terminated. Again P1 will move to link of P1. So link of P1 is null. So it will also not repeat. So this way all the steps perform, and you can see link list is sorted in ascending order, 20-34. And if you want to perform sorting in descending order, you can just change this greater than sign with less than sign. So all the values will be arranged in decreasing order. So this way, I hope you understood how we can write algorithm to sort a linked list. And if you want to watch more algorithms related videos, so you can go to description of this video. You will find links of playlist related to data structures and algorithm and implementation of DSA using C language. So watch those playlists. They contain several videos related to data structure so that you can learn DSA well. Thank you for watching this video.